Hello all, I am Veer from electronicsinnovation.com. Today we are going to unbox these devices: a Bluetooth bridge gateway, a fingerboard which can be controlled over the Bluetooth, and a tool pack of fingerboard. Then we will register them on the Tuya Smart IoT app and try to control them wirelessly. This bridge gateway comes with a micro USB cable to power up the module. The gateway is not battery operated, it needs continuous power supply. The fingerboard comes with a 3M double-sided plaster. This double-sided plaster is used to place the module in the desired location. This fingerboard also comes with a Type-C data cable to charge the module. Basically, the fingerboard is battery operated. Since it is based on Bluetooth Low Energy, it consumes very little power, so the battery lasts long. As we have two fingerboards, we got two sets of accessories here. Coming to the tool pack, it contains two wooden blocks. I don't know where we can use them. We have to explore the possibilities. This tool pack contains extra 3M double-sided plaster of different sizes. Also, we got some extra handles for fingerboard for different applications, maybe for other switches and all. Now let us set up the devices and register them on the Tuya Smart IoT Cloud. First of all, turn on the devices using the onboard button. When it's turned on, the onboard LED will flicker and the finger will move up and down. Now take out your mobile and install the Tuya Smart app from Play Store. Then sign up. On the home page, click on the Add Device button. It will show some instructions that will help us in successful pairing. Read them carefully. Switch to auto scan mode and enable all permissions for scanning devices. Then click on Start Scanning. You will find available devices on the screen. Click on Next. Select any device and try to add it. At this point, the Tuya Smart app will register the device in the Tuya Smart IoT Cloud and initialize the device. After successful adding, you can edit your device name as shown here. Then click on Done. Repeat the same process for another device. That's it. Both devices are successfully registered on the Tuya Smart app. Now we can control the fingerboards from app itself. There are two modes of switching. When the switch mode is off, the finger will move forward and went back to the normal position as shown here. Whenever the switch mode is on, the finger will move forward and stay there. This is for switching the normal switches. The inward switch mode will help us to reverse the switch operation. Let's test the second fingerboard now. It's fun, right? I'm enjoying a lot by controlling and switching all these boards. I like it very much. Now let us set up this gateway and register it on the Tuya Smart app. Then connect these fingerboards to the gateway. Power up the gateway and press and hold the onboard button to put the gateway in the pairing mode. Open Tuya Smart app and click on Add Devices. Switch to Auto Scan. If you find the Bluetooth bridge gateway like this, click on Next. Provide the Wi-Fi credentials such as SSID and password and then click Next. Normally, the SSID is automatically fetched from the current Wi-Fi connection. It will take some time to register the gateway on the Tuya Smart Cloud. After successful registration, you can find the Bluetooth bridge gateway on the top of the home page. Go into that. Choose an option to add the devices by list. Select the both fingerboards and confirm it. Then choose the option immediately to join. That's it. Two devices are connected to the gateway. If you wanted to delete any device, you can do it from here. Now, let's test the fingerboards. As you can see here, we are able to control them seamlessly. We are able to control both devices turn on and turn off in both switching modes. Let us test them again by turning off the mobile's Bluetooth so that we can confirm that there is no Bluetooth connection present between fingerboard and mobile device. Even after turning off the Bluetooth connection, we are able to control them. This means there is another connection medium. Previously, both devices are controlled over the Bluetooth connection between mobile phone and fingerboards. But after setting up gateway, the devices are connected to the gateway. The gateway connected to the Tuya cloud over the Wi-Fi internet. The gateway will allow us to control the fingerboards from anywhere in the world. I repeat, anywhere in the world, because the internet is enabled. If at all the fingerboard is discharged, we can recharge it using Type-C USB port provided here. All we have to do is to connect it to any DC 5 volts power supply, such as power banks, chargers, adapters, etc. Till now we have seen controlling fingerboards using Tuya Smart App. As we all are electronics engineers, we cannot stop here. We have to move a step ahead. So we will see how to control fingerboard with Tuya Cloud Development Platform APIs. Visit the Tuya Smart Intelligent IoT platform and register by providing all the required details if you are the first time user. Then log into the platform using the same credentials. This is the homepage of Tuya Smart IoT platform. Here you can see the devices we have developed in the previous video. Previously we have worked on the product section, but now we are going to work on the cloud section. Go to the cloud and then choose development. Now we have to subscribe to the cloud development platform according to our requirements. Here we have 4 type of plans: 1. Trial edition, 2. Basic edition, 3. Advanced edition, and the final one, Ultimate edition. For the demonstration, a trial edition is enough. So we will choose the trial edition now. Again, choose trial edition here. If you select any other plan, we have to pay the below mentioned amount. Then click on the buy now. Then submit the order. That's it. We have successfully subscribed to the trial edition of Tuya IoT platform services. Then come back to the main page and click on subscribe. Now click on the create cloud project and enter the following details. Project name, whatever you want. Industry, smart home. Development method, smart home. And the availability zone, your country. I am from India, so India selected. Then click on create and then authorize the selected default API products. These 5 APIs are enough for us for this particular task. That's it, a new cloud project is created. Here we have different sections like overview, authorization, service API, assets, users, and devices. We will be working on this section. Now we have to add devices here. We can add devices in 3 different ways. Since we have already registered the devices on the Tuya Smart App, we can simply link the Tuya App account and import the devices directly here. Click on Add App Account. A QR code will be generated and appears on the screen. Now open the Tuya Smart App on your mobile and go to the Add Devices. Click on the QR code scanner on the top right corner and scan the QR code. Then confirm the login. That's it, you have successfully linked Tuya Smart IoT App and Tuya Smart IoT Cloud easily. I liked this feature so much, hassle-free linking of both platforms within fraction of seconds. This is what we want from any cloud or app provider. Here you can see the linked account, the app name, and the number of devices are registered on the app appeared here. Now come back to the all devices. Here you can see the 4 devices we have added to the Tuya Smart App. Bluetooth Bridge Gateway, Fingerboard 2, Fingerboard 1, EI Tuya Demo LED, which we have added previously. If you didn't find these devices, make sure you have selected the right region in the Device Manage section, which is in Overview. If you find the devices, copy the device ID and go to the API Explorer. On the left panel, you find a lot of APIs. Let's go to the Get Device Details API. Paste the device ID we have previously copied and hit the Submit Request button. On the right side, you can see all details of the device, the status, whether the device turned on or turned off, false means turned off. a mode, whether it is switch or click, a battery percentage, charging status, every single detail of the fingerboard can be accessed from here. These are the device management APIs. Let's go to the device control APIs. Click on Control Device API. Enter the device ID. To control the fingerboard, we have to provide the command here, the controlling command. We can see the format specifier of the command in this API. Just enter the device ID and hit submit the request. You can see all the keywords here. For example, if you wanted to turn on the fingerboard, we have to enter the following command. Then submit the request. Here we got a response, illegal parameter. I think we have to put the command in the square braces. Again, submit the request. Yes, now it turned on. Now edit the command to change the value false. Now the fingerboard turned off. If the value is true, the device turned on. If the value is false, the device turned off. Yeah, this is how we can control the fingerboard from the Tuya Intelligent Smart IoT platform using the open APIs. Now let's test the fingerboard tool. Come back to the device page, copy the fingerboard 2 device ID, paste it over here. Change the value to true. Boom! The fingerboard 2 turned on. Again, change the value to false. Now it's turned off. True, turned on. False, turned off. The first time there is some delay in executing commands, but the second time it is quick. I think this small delay is acceptable. That's it for this tutorial. This is how we can control the fingerboard devices from Tuya Smart IoT app as well as the Tuya Smart IoT platform using the APIs. This is just a trailer of Tuya Smart IoT platform capabilities. We will explore more capabilities and more features of Tuya Smart IoT platform in coming videos. So stay tuned to Electronics Innovation for more interesting videos on Tuya Smart IoT platform. See you on the next interesting episode. Bye bye.